Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Grad Coach TV. My name's Derek, and in this episode, we're going to be looking at a reference management software called Mendeley. It's a very popular reference manager. We've spoken about Zotero previously on Grad Coach TV, but some of you have come back and said, hey, could you do a video on Mendeley? I've heard it's really good. So in this episode, we're going to be looking at how to use Mendeley, in particular Mendeley Desktop, as well as the Mendeley Web Importer and the Microsoft Word integration. So let's have a look at it. Right, so the first thing you're going to have to do is download the Mendeley software. You can get that on Mendeley's website. That's mendeley.com. Click the Reference Management tab in the top left and click the Download Now button. Mendeley is available for Windows, it's available for Mac, it's available for Linux, so you shouldn't have any problems in terms of compatibility. And then just go ahead, download and install it. Alright, so once that's installed, you'll have a piece of software that looks something like this. Now yours might have a pop-up message because it's your first time using it, and that's fine, you can just close it. I'll show you how to do everything from within the software. So this is your home base, this is Mendeley Desktop. The first thing that you want to do is install all the add-ons. So to do that, you'll go to the Tools menu, and you'll say Install Web Importer and install the Microsoft Word plugin. Once those are installed, you're ready to go. Okay, so the first thing you've got to do is populate your reference management tool, in this case, Mendeley. Now, this is standard for pretty much any software. You're always going to have to populate first before you can go and drop citations into a document. Thankfully, Mendeley has a few ways to do this, and some of them are really easy. So let's take a look at the options. All right, the first option you have in terms of bringing your citations or bringing your literature into Mendeley is quite simply just to drag and drop the PDF files that you have into the interface. So for example, here I have a collection of various resources, and if I just take one and drop it straight into Mendeley, you can see that not only is it listed here, but it's fully populated on this side, including the year, the volume, the issue, abstract, etc. So this is really, really handy. This can really save you time. There is, however, a massive limitation in that this only really works for journal articles. So if you're importing anything other than a journal article, if it's, say, a chapter of a textbook or anything other than a journal article, it probably won't be as good. You can certainly give it a try, but it might not have the right information. What is really great about dropping a PDF file straight into Mendeley is that it actually goes and saves it. You'll see down at the bottom right here, it goes and saves it into the software. So not only do you have all your records, all your citations in one place, but you can actually easily access the PDF directly from Mendeley, which is pretty neat. Right, the second way to populate your Mendeley database is to use Mendeley's built-in literature search functionality. So let's have a look at that. So to use this function, you'll just go up to the literature search button up in the top left over here, and then you just basically search for whatever keyword or title of a journal article you're looking for. So I'll just search for something generic like trust, and Mendeley returns a whole lot of options. So you'll see that for each of these, it has full details, it has the abstract, it has all the details of the journal article. So that's really handy, provided what you're searching for is a journal article or a well-known piece of work. So to import any of these into my database, I'll just go and click the Save Reference button up top here. I'm going to install a few or import a few just so that we have something to work with at a later stage. Right, so then going back to my document library, you can see that I now have quite a few options here in terms of the literature that is in my database. So the literature search functionality is really handy when you're searching for a journal article or something that is widely published in academic circles. But if you want to import, or if you want to cite a web page, for example, say a blog post from a reputable source, you're not going to have the record within that literature search database. So what you then do is you use Mendeley's web importer function, which we installed just a little earlier. So let's take a look at that. So once you've installed the Mendeley Web Importer, you'll see that it has a little icon, or that you have a new little icon in the top right of your browser. In this case, I'm using Firefox. You might use something else. There's support for all the major browsers. So let's say we want to cite the article on this page right now. So this is from Entrepreneur and it's a news article. What you'll then do is, while we're on the page, click this little button up here. And we'll need to sign into the account. And once we've signed in, we'll see a screen that looks like this. So as you can see, Mendeley's automatically detected that it's a web page, surprise, surprise, and it's populated the title. Now, in some cases, it will populate the author name and other information, but for the most part, it's really up to you to go and populate this. Once you've done that, you can click save, and that will automatically feed straight into your Mendeley database. All right, so those are three pretty easy ways to import or at least to find the right information. But sometimes you're just going to be left to manually insert data into the Mendeley database. And let's just have a quick look at how you do that. So in the Mendeley desktop app, you're just going to right click in this white area over here and you're going to say add entry manually. First thing you need to select is the type of resource. So that might be a book section, it might be a piece of film, it might be an encyclopedia article. You just select what's appropriate and you fill in the data and it will go and populate. Pretty straightforward. Right, so now you've got your Mendeley database nice and populated. You've got all your resources in that you want to cite. And the next step is naturally to go drop it into a Word document. So let's take a look at how you do that. Once you've installed the Mendeley Microsoft Word add-in, which we did right in the beginning, you'll see that there's a new option in the References tab of your Microsoft Word. And you'll see that the biggest button says Insert Citation, so this is pretty straightforward. But before you do that, the first thing you need to do is select your style. In other words, Harvard, APA, whatever your preference is or whatever the requirement of the university is. So you'll click the little drop-down over there, and you'll usually find most of the popular ones in this dropdown. But if not, you can go to More Styles and you'll have the option to go and search for more styles. There are a lot of variants on the Harvard style, for example, and you'll find them if you just search using the keyword Harvard. You'll see all the options over here. All right, so you've selected the style that you need. For this example, let's just choose Elsevier Harvard. And you're going to naturally have two requirements. One is to insert citations and the other is to build a reference list. So to insert citations, it's pretty straightforward. You would just write your text as you normally would, and then when it comes time to insert the citation, you just literally click that button up there, search for the relevant citation, and in it goes. So let's just do this a few times so that there's something of a list to work with. Let's insert one over there. And let's just do one more. Okay, so there we have three options, or rather three references, citations that have been put into a document. And it's now time to build a reference list. But before we do that, let's just look at how one goes about changing the formatting if you need to. So in this instance, we've gone and we've used a standard citation format where it is first our statement and then just a citation to the author. If you want to give the author a more authoritative voice in your writing, what you can do is quite simply just change the style by manually intervening. And the moment you do this, Mendeley will ask you if you actually want to edit, and you'll say yes, you do. So in this case, we're just changing it to Glazer et al, and we are parenthesizing the year and then onward. So those are just two different styles of citation, or two different ways of writing. And thankfully, Mendeley allows you to just edit inline and will still save the reference, no problem. So the last thing you want to do, obviously, is build your reference list. And it couldn't be easier. You just write your title out. This would usually be on a new page. And you click Insert Bibliography. And there you have it. Mendeley has gone and built your entire bibliography, all up to date, as per the data that you have in the Mendeley database. So that's Mendeley Reference Management Software. We've looked at the desktop version, we've looked at the web importer, and of course the Microsoft Word integration. Overall, fantastic piece of software. There's a reason it's so popular. If you haven't chosen a reference management software yet, this is a great option. If you're using Zotero, as I previously recommended, and you had a look at this video and said, well, this looks better, Mendeley does have an import option, so you can just import or relocate all of your data from Zotero through to Mendeley. It's up to you, both pieces of software. We are great. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section or get in touch with us. Our email is hello@grad.coach. This is Derek from Grad Coach signing out.